Shalom, my Hebrew nation. My name is Daria, and I would like to introduce the love of my life, my wife, Aisha.
Hello.
We've been married for 15 years, and we are the founders of the Hebrew Israelites Recommits Organization. We have been commissioned by the Most High Yah to galvanize His Hebrew people in preparation for our exodus. We're going back to our home nation, y'all, Israel.
All right. Okay. Shalom, Hebrew nation.
Shalom.
It's been a while since we've been on.
Yes, almost about a month together.
Yeah,
it's been a while. We miss you guys. We're excited to bring this following video, this following lesson for our nation. And we hope that it will help your growth. It will help guide you. And it will be as a mentor or a mentor to you as well. Something tangible that you can fall back on as a point of reference.
Right. And we also, the title of this lesson is called The Code, Part 1. So this is not part of our Lesson 12 series. We have that on our playlist. We need you, if you haven't already, we say this every video, go back to Lesson 12, Part 1, and work your way back up to Part 7. Lesson 12, Part 1 through Part 7. Because that is like a crash course on what we are about. And where the nation is headed. Also, Black Empowerment Deception 1, 2, and 3. That's also on our playlist. You need to hear those as well as some powerful information in there. This is not about listening to our videos. This is about knowing what time it is for us
as
a nation.
And it serves as an action plan.
Yeah.
And I also encourage you guys, if you have not already, to visit our website at www.thiro.org, where you can learn more about the mission. And from day one, our mission has not changed. It will not change.
And it will succeed.
And it will succeed.
That's right. You done?
I was done, yeah, okay. With the intro.
So, if you guys know anything about us, you know I like to jump right into the title. So, we're going to talk about the title today. We're going to jump right into this. It's called The Code, Part 1. Okay? So, my first point I want to talk about is the myth of white supremacy. I was talking about previous lessons, I said go back to lesson 2. That we covered this, what I'm saying about the myth, it's titled The Myth of White Supremacy in great detail. And then lesson 12, part 3, I cover that in great detail, the myth of white supremacy. And the reason why we call it a myth is because we know that that's what it is. Meaning, this system, this beast, okay, called white supremacy, has never been about the color of our skin. It has everything to do with the fact that we're Jacob and the European nations is Esau. And that is what the system is. It has nothing to do with the color of your skin, but in order to sell it to the whole world, they had to say, make up something. So, oh, it's because they're black.
Right.
No, it's the Hebrew blood running through your vein, Jacob versus Esau. That's what this is. It has nothing to do with the color of your skin. It never has.
And this is an ancient old battle
yes.
that has been going on since the beginning of time.
Two nations are in your womb.
Yes.
Book of Genesis. From Genesis through Revelation.
Yes.
Okay. And they took 100 books out of our sacred history, by the way.
Yes.
Okay. Which is the Apocrypha. You all need to click on the link in the description box for that. I'll talk about that. Especially the Book of Jasher. Because that's a strong history book. You can start out with that one. Okay.
And it deals with lineage, and it also deals with the children of Jacob throughout Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob throughout the bloodlines and what the children grew up to become and do.
The 12 sons of Jacob, which is the 12 tribes of
Israel
today.
Exactly.
Okay. So, like I said, that was my first point. The myth of white supremacy has never been about the color of our skin. Now, I want to talk about the last video that we did, lesson together, because you put a few up since then, which is lesson 12, part 7. And on the ending of the video, we talked about a code.
Yes, code of conduct, yes.
Okay, hold on, I'm going to take a drink of water. Sorry about that. We talked about a code. And we also, see, for other nations, this would be simple. But for us, that's in our infancy stage, daughter Zion. You need to understand, the Bible refers to our ancestors as Virgin Israel. That's the very first Israel, came over, first Exodus, took over Israel. We were a nation of people. Because we were cursed, our people were enslaved. the Lord refers to us as daughter Zion.
Daughter Zion.
We're the descendants of the very first Israel, which the Bible refers to as Virgin Israel. Okay? Stay with me. So, we are daughter Zion. We are the descendants of the first Israel, Virgin Israel. And what I mean for other nations, a code of conduct is very simple because they've been nations forever.
Yes.
They never ceased to be nations. Even with all the beasts and the
colonization,
they weren't made to forget their language, their culture, and who they were as a people. Not even Africans. No one was made to forget who they were completely but us. Mm-hmm. They lied and told us we were a bunch of scattered tribes all over Africa that happened to get enslaved through war, which is a complete damn lie. Okay. Mm-hmm. They came to Africa looking for Hebrews because we lost our land in 70 AD. So our ancestors migrated down into the west coast of Africa, and that is where we were. Mm-hmm. Okay. So it's no different than we're here in Chicago. Mm-hmm. If someone wants to say, where's your Chinatown? I'll point them right to 22nd and Sarmat. Mm-hmm. You know, if someone was to say, where's your little Mexico? Mm-hmm. I'll point them over on Kezi and Montrose. That's where they are. Where's your Thai town? I'll point them over to Argyle. Mm-hmm. So it's the same thing with us. We were immigrants in West Africa. And when, along with the Moors, when Esau came looking for Hebrews, they said, there they are over there.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what happened. So they knew who we were. And they knew who they were coming to get. They knew they were coming to get Jacob. They knew that. Mm-hmm. Okay, they lied and told you this myth that is Africa. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Really? Okay. So, let's go back to that. We need to go back to what we talked about in the last video, which was a code of conduct for our nation. And, you know, the Most High, I was on my son porch earlier this week, and he told me clear as day, not audibly, but I knew. He said, my people need therapy, mm-hmm. right? And I'm like, therapy? I'm like, okay, we all can't go to like psychiatrists. Like everybody, and besides, they're mostly Esau anyway.
Right.
He said, no, my people need therapy. And he pointed me to this. And he said, tell my people that this is what they need. This is what we want to deal with because we have a problem. Okay, honey. What is the definition of, there's like 30 types of therapy, but this is what the Most High said his nation need.
Right.
As a people.
Our nation suffers from what's called CBT, which is cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, is a short-term therapy technique that can help people find new ways to behave by changing their thought patterns. Mm. Engaging with CBT can help people reduce stress, cope with complicated relationships, deal with grief, and face many other common life challenges.
Okay. So, that's what we want to talk about. The Most High Yah said we need therapy. And I want you to read up to that one more time, up to the point where he says we need to change our thought patterns. He said this is the kind of therapy. He said my nation need therapy.
So, if you are in a position to go to pay for a psychiatrist or psychologist or whatever the case may be, preferably, I wouldn't suggest it because, again, we don't have enough of our own people in those industries. And the Most I have designed you perfectly to do all this healing within yourself.
This is, if you listen to these lessons, you need to listen to these lessons like we told you, lesson 12, part one. And this is, that's what I'm saying. It's about thought patterns. So yes. You don't need to go see a psychiatrist for right. that. This is what the Lord's saying we need. What is that first sentence for the definition?
The definition is cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, is a short-term therapy technique mm-hmm. that can help people find new ways to behave by changing their thought patterns.
Exactly. That's your therapy. Changing your thought patterns.
Changing your thoughts. The way you think. Everything that we learned from our childhood was a lie. Our parents taught us lies.
They
didn't know it. You know? So we can't even really hold them at fault for a lot of things. Mm-hmm. But the thing that can be held at fault to anyone is when truth has been revealed and you choose to reject the truth.
Right. And you need to understand this is extremely important for our second Exodus. We're getting to a point here. Stay with us. So the Most High Yah says that my people need therapy. That's what he gave me. Mm-hmm. And when I say that's what he gave me, I mean that's what he gave me. Okay. He said, my people need therapy. And I'm going to tell you why. And the therapy he said we need is that of changing your behavior and thought process.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
But you change it? Your thought patterns, your behavior automatically change.
Exactly.
Period.
Exactly. There you go, honey. So, I want to talk about the Willie Lynch letter. We getting to a point here. We love you. We getting to a point here. So, what you need to understand about the Willie Lynch letter, once again, Esau is trying to lie.
Mm-hmm.
And say that this letter did not exist. You guys, that's a bunch of BS. We're living it.
They also lied. I've seen people on YouTube, Hebrew people on YouTube at that, would say that a Hebrew or a black man wrote the Willie Lynch letter. That's
lie.
Why it's called Willie Lynch.
No. No, they're not going to. Okay, listen. The Willie Lynch letter is real. That's impossible for it not to be real. We live in it every day. Of course it was real. And let me tell you something else. He didn't just give one speech in Virginia, like we're about to talk about. Mm-hmm. Willie Lynch was an evil slave master that owned some of our people in the West Indies. You know, our people in the West Indies, the descendants of slaves there in the West Indies. And he trained the Americas, Canada, all throughout the South. He went about traveling to train other evil slave owners how to condition, brainwash their slaves.
Mm-hmm.
You have to understand, we always talk about this system of white supremacy where you got the legislation, you control the jobs, you control all those things, but how did you control the mind?
Mm-hmm.
That's the part of this beast, the Willie Lynch, that did that.
Mm-hmm.
And the Willie Lynch letter was like a user's manual.
Yes.
It was circulated all throughout the world. This is what you do to condition a slave. Esau's not that smart. How do you think they one being one sound as far as controlling us and controlling our ancestors?
They had a playbook.
They had a playbook, which is the Willie Lynch letter, and which is what we're about to read a part of that to you now. Listen up, my Hebrew nation. This is extremely important for our second Exodus.
And if you know anything about the Willie Lynch letter, the very thought to put those thoughts on paper to be able to take it viral around the world at that time with no internet,
mm-hmm.
someone paid for your travel to go and speak it.
Yeah.
Someone paid for you to print it up,
mm-hmm.
to have it massively distributed.
Right.
So for Esau himself to create that letter in itself, you already know it's impossible. The devil had to give Esau this letter.
Well, and it says that the beast, it was the beast is authority comes from the devil.
The devil
itself. So if white supremacy seemed demonic, that's because it is.
It is.
Very. You know, we went over that. Like I said, go back to our previous lesson. We went over that in great detail.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, especially part 3, lesson 12. Okay, now. I want to cover this Willie Lynch letter that was distributed throughout the world to all evil slave owners and their overseers and even other people of Esau.
Yes.
This is what they did to us. This is part of the system. This is of white supremacy. This is part of the beast. They controlled everything physically, but how did you control the minds? This is what we're talking about. Okay, honey, if you could start that out.
Okay. In my bag here.
This Willie Lynch talking.
I have a foolproof method for controlling your black slaves. I guarantee every one of you that if installed correctly, it will control slaves for at least 300 years.
Mm.
My method is simple, and members of your family and any overseer can use it.
Okay, this is double. This is the beginning of his speech when he used to go around, you know, touring,
mm-hmm.
with his demonic user's manual for slaves.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, continue, honey.
I have outlined a number of differences among the slaves.
Can you repeat that one line?
I have outlined a number of differences among the slaves.
Okay.
And I take these differences and make them bigger.
Yes.
I use fear, distrust, and envy for control purposes.
You see what these devils did, and they all jumped on cold.
Mm-hmm.
This was a user's manual when they owned slaves on what to do with our minds. Okay, keep going, honey.
Okay, again, I want to repeat that. I use fear, distrust, and envy for control purposes. These methods have worked on my modest plantation in the West Indies, and it will work throughout the South. Take this simple little list of differences. Think about them. On top of my list is age. A-G-E. Age.
Woody Lynch talking.
But it is there only because it starts with an A. The second is color or shade.
Can you repeat that one part?
The second is color or shade.
So Esau said, make the differences about, also about one of them is color or shade.
Right.
Okay, we're going to make that clear. We're coming back to that.
There is intelligence, size, mm-hmm. sex, size of plantation.
Sex, gender war.
Yeah.
Is that not still going on today?
Yeah.
Male versus female. No other nation fight like that. They mm-hmm. make babies in love, not war, against yeah. each other. We dysfunctional. Okay, keep going.
There is intelligence, size, sex, size of plantation, status on plantation, attitude of owner, whether the slaves live in the valley, on the hill, east, west, north, south, have fine hair or coarse hair, or is tall or short.
Mm.
Now that you have a list of differences, I should give you an outline of action.
You hear that? Can you repeat that part? Now that you have a list of differences among the slaves, I'm going to give you an outline of action. Can you?
Yeah. Now that you have a list of differences, I should give you an outline of action.
Manual. These devils distributed this worldwide. This was a user's manual. That's a lie. He didn't get one speech in Virginia. He went around the world to all of the Europeans giving this training.
Mm-hmm.
It was printed. It was distributed. It was a user's manual. Go ahead, honey, finish up.
But before that, I shall assure you that distrust is stronger than trust. And envy is stronger than adulation, respect, or admiration.
Wow. Okay.
The black slaves, after receiving this indoctrination, shall carry on and will become self-refueling and self-generating for hundreds of years, maybe thousands.
I'm so sorry to have you do it, honey, but I need you to repeat that sentence. They need to get that.
The black slaves, after receiving this indoctrination, shall carry on and will become self-refueling and self-generating for hundreds of years, maybe thousands.
Did you hear that? So he's saying, even though we're going to keep doing it, we don't even have to do it. Once we indoctrinate them, they'll do it to themselves. This brainwashing will be so perfect if we do it perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
Then they won't, we won't even have to keep doing it. They'll do it to themselves. The differences with shades and all that. Okay, keep going. The gender war. Okay.
Don't forget, you must pitch the old black versus the young black male.
Wow.
And the young black male versus the old black male. You must use the dark skinned slaves versus the light skinned slaves.
One more time, that one part.
You must use the dark skinned slaves versus the light-skinned slaves.
Okay.
And the light-skinned slaves versus the dark-skinned slaves. You must also have your white servants and overseers distrust all blacks.
Mm.
But it is necessary they trust and depend on us.
Wow.
They must love, respect, and trust only us.
So he's saying, you make sure you never trust a Hebrew.
You make sure you never go against your own Esau nation, especially for a Hebrew.
Right. But they must be faithful to us.
Exactly.
And not their own people.
Exactly. But the Hebrew, the black slave, must be faithful to us
mm-hmm.
only and that, not each other.
That was the code. That was the system. That was trained. That was a manual. It was circulated worldwide.
And okay. Again, let me read it because that is so powerful. Understand, This is Esau's plan from the Willie letter, and it is playing out like a perfect fine-tuned piano.
Yeah. They don't even have to do it, we'll do it.
This is the goal of the Willie Lynch letter and how it affects our nation today, 2019.
The Hebrew nation, not America, you all. They love yeah. America, Jesus.
You must also have your white servants and overseers distrust all blacks. Now he's talking about the blacks, but it is necessary they trust and depend on us. Mm. The blacks must love, respect, and trust only us.
Right. There you go.
There you go.
Okay. That's what we want to talk about. Listen up, my Hebrew nation. We love you. But like I said, let's go back to what I said before we read that disgusting, demonic system that they implemented on our minds. Okay? Which is the Willie Lynch letter. The Most High said, my people need therapy. That's what he's talking about. Because he's trying to get you ready. He's getting you ready for the second exodus. It's time for us to be our own nation once again.
Yes.
I want you to understand that the Most High is a nationalist. That's why he said in the Bible, even for the second exodus, everybody go home to their own nation.
Yeah.
Everybody go home to their own nation. Everybody go home. Hebrews, you going back home to Israel. Everybody go home to their own nation. The Most High Yah goes by bloodline. He does not go by color. Okay? Esau taught you that. I told you, that's go back to what I said about the myth of white supremacy. It's never been about color. It's about bloodline. They're Esau, we're Jacob. He has never gone by color. Okay? Now, there are Hebrews, only Hebrews. Hebrews are Negroes, meaning on the map where we were in Africa, they called that Negro land. Now, Esau perverted it by calling us niggers, but we are Negroes. We're the Negro race. There is no Latino Hebrews. That's a bunch of bullcrap. That's not the case. But Hebrews are of the Negroid race.
Yeah.
Real talk. And I'm proud of it.
Yeah.
Okay?
I'm a nigga, he's a nigga, she's a nigga, we some niggas, wouldn't you like to be a nigga too?
Well, that's what, I mean, well, yeah.
That's for my NWA fans.
Right, but and you know, that's what I'm saying too. When they perverted it and start calling us niggers, because we were Negroes, mm-hmm. We're Negroes from Negro land, and they erased that off the map, you all.
Yeah.
Go back to before 1600, there was a space on the map called Negro land. That's yeah. for us. So even when they perverted it and started putting the ER at the end of it and made it a byword, like
right.
Deuteronomy 28 say, we took it and turned it into something brotherly.
Right.
What's up, my nigga? That's
right.
Okay. So for you all that have a problem with that, we just took what they did and turned it into something brotherly. That's mm-hmm. it. Okay. Anyway, that's just a side note. Saying all that to say, the Most High Yah is a nationalist. He goes by bloodline. That's why he gave everybody their own what?
Nation.
Okay?
Yeah.
And so when we talk about colorism, like you must put the dark against the light and the light against the dark, that's Esau. Esau did that. He made it about skin color, and that's what I mean when I say the myth of white supremacy. I'm getting to a point here. I want to talk to you. Listen up, my Hebrew nation. I want to talk about this colorism thing, you know, because we had this debate going on with natural hair weave. That's that Willie Lynch, that's small. You must mm-hmm. Enlarge the small things among them. And I have seen that die down a lot. Keep that up. I'm not hearing it. Good. I don't want to hear about natural hair weave because that's stupid. Okay. That's number one. Some of the men jumped into that fight too. That's mm-hmm. stupid. Okay. And sometimes women I have a few family members who they have some hair problems that they actually going bald in some spots, so they have to wear wigs.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So you all have not been keeping that up. That has died down a lot since we mentioned it. I'm proud of that. Keep that up, okay? But I got to tell you, it was the natural hair movement that was attacking the sister that wear the weaves.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying the women that wear weaves are perfect. But I'm saying they wasn't attacking you for wearing natural hair. But y'all, the natural hair sisters, I have natural hair, by the way, besides when I wear braids. The natural hair sisters were attacking the sisters that wear the weave. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Which is, okay, that's not happening a lot now. I didn't see it die down a lot. Like I said, keep that up. Don't pick that back up. But now, honey, it's like they colorism has always been among us, the mm-hmm. Willie Lynch, but it's like they crank that up since they can't talk about natural and weave anymore. They start cranking up the colorism.
And you know me, I just think like this. I'm cynical in a way. Mm-hmm. I feel that the reason the resurgence in the colorism came back, because again, we killed the Back to Ghana. Mm-hmm. We killed the ADOS. Mm-hmm. We killed the Black Empowerment Deception. Mm-hmm. We killing all these false narratives, and as soon as we kill it, these people, they say, okay, we can't talk about that no more. We on this.
Yeah.
As if you're doing good.
F-ing up. Yeah. It's ridiculous.
You just went from one divisive propaganda mechanism to another one.
Exactly, and that's what we want to talk about. Because you, I want to talk to my dark-skinned sisters. You understand? Okay, number one, because I know you're not gonna like it, but I have to tell you the truth. I'm not concerned about your feelings. I'm concerned about your soul, okay? And the dark Hebrew sisters, they are the ones that's keeping up the colorism.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hearing that. Listen up. I know that you all have been traumatized by your own nation, as well as the whole world. May being made fun of because your skin is darker, mm-hmm. or not being seen as attractive, and all the propaganda in your own nation, even doing that because they're all Willie Lynch.
Mm-hmm.
I get it. I get it, my dark-skinned Hebrews. I get that. But guess what? We all have been traumatized by this beast.
Yes.
You're not the only one that's been traumatized and brainwashed and abused by this beast. Okay? So that don't give you the right to keep being divisive. And that is what you're doing. I'm hearing it too damn much. And you know,
and you're doing it for the sake of clicks,
yeah,
likes, subscribers, and hoping that a debate or conversation goes viral. But while you're debating these differences among our own nation.
Right.
No problems are getting solved. The only thing you're creating is more destruction and more problems.
And more divisiveness. Like Esau taught you.
And some of you, and we're going to touch on this later. I don't want to jump ahead. We're going to touch on this later. The Willie Lynch letter, even though it didn't mention this, it morphs into every fabric of life. So now the Willie Lynch letter simply said dark versus light. But we have gone into areas of putting our own rich versus the poor.
Mm-hmm.
You're the same people.
Well, it says that in the Willie
Lynch. I know, but
they house Negroes and the field Negroes were separate.
Yeah,
they
ones that live in the valley on the hill and the ones who don't.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
But okay, to bring it down to layman's term for this time, we even saw some of that. You're attacking your rich brothers and sisters, and that's only going to bring divisiveness between the rich and the poor among us.
Right. And we're too fragile for that. We're daughter Zion.
Yes.
Stop with the colorism. It's disgusting.
And if you don't have anything else to say,
shut up.
But that stuff, that's your cue. Get off YouTube and go work on yourself.
Exactly. Because I'm hearing it too much. You know, there's this there's this cesspool. I hope she's over 25 because I'm about to get her. I'm sick of it. Chrissy, her channel, Chrissy. She. First of all she does, she's completely Willie Lynch. Mm-hmm. She definitely need therapy. Okay, mm-hmm. It's sickening. First of all, there are more than dark skinned Hebrew women.
Yes.
Silly. All she push is dark skinned Hebrew women, and then she always put the women against the men. So she's divisive on every level. That's why I call her a cesspool.
Yeah.
Okay, and you know, there are dark-skinned Hebrew sisters, there are light-skinned Hebrew sisters, there's the middle child like me. No one ever talks about the caramel or peanut butter complexion. Mm-hmm. Okay, there are more. That's divisive in itself. You act like the only women, Hebrew women on the planet is dark-skinned.
And I'm not going to mention any names, but we have specific Hebrew women whose only goal and reason for being on YouTube is to attack Hebrew men and vice versa.
It's
Hebrew men who have channels that only serves to debate and attack the Black Hebrew women based on things that they have no control over,
right?
No power over, no authority over to change.
You Willie Lynched. It's disgusting. Esau put that with you. Esau told you that shade matter. God goes by bloodline. He doesn't go by your shade. He don't go by your shade. Stop the colorism. I'm hearing it too damn much. And you know what? I love our whole nation, but even someone, you know, calling our light-skinned brothers and sisters pale.
Yeah.
That is not a compliment. That is the put-down. That's divisive. It doesn't matter how you transpend it. Do not call light-skinned brothers and sisters pale. That, you know, that's a name. Your name called.
And I must say this because it just dropped in my spirit. And for my Hebrew sisters and my Hebrew brothers who love the debate, they wake up to debate a new issue or a new story or a new storyline. But if you really think about it, the art of debating was never created to solve anything.
Right.
It was created to keep the subject of the problem being talked about or researched.
Exactly.
Because the emphasis on a debate is no one knows the answer. Mm-hmm. So we're going to talk about it. Let's talk about it.
Like philosophy.
You're a crapshoot philosopher.
Right.
What's the point of a debate if there's no sound, solid answer?
Division.
It's division. That's what is created. When there is no solution to a debate, it creates division, more separation, and it elevates and illuminates more of that same problem and issue, because now you have hundreds, if not millions, of people chiming in on either side.
Yeah.
It perpetual goes through the world as an unsolved mystery, but we can talk about it.
And while we're doing that, Esau killing us some more. They're killing us.
It sets you up as a perfect distraction so Esau can continue to kill our babies, kill us. And guess what you're going to do about that situation? You're going to debate. You're going to talk about it.
Stop with the colorism, right?
Yeah.
And the gender war didn't quiet down a little bit, but I'm still hearing it's
starting
much.
To percolate a little bit back up when that colorism came back.
Yeah, yeah.
The gender war came back real strong.
Stop it. You Willie lynched.
And that's what I meant. We have specific Hebrew women whose channels only were created to promote the gender war, the female versus the male.
Well, we're going to talk about that more in the next lesson, too, because we're not done with that.
And vice versa, we have Hebrew males who created YouTube channels specifically to engage in a gender war and put down our Hebrew women.
That's just sick.
It really is sickening.
It's Willie Lynch, just demonic. They said, if we do it right, we won't even have to do it. They'll do it to themselves.
And again, if you are a Hebrew male or a Hebrew female who are currently engaging in this type of divisiveness on YouTube, that is your cue to get off YouTube and go work on yourself within, heal yourself, and get some wisdom and understanding and some knowledge. Then when you're mature enough, then you're able to come back and talk to masses of people, because now you have some sense.
Okay, that's what we're bringing. We want to talk about something right here. I want to go to the book of Ruth. Let's get some scripture to back this. We on the colorism. I want to talk about this. Let's get Ruth chapter 4, verses 13 through 22. Now, if anybody know the background of Ruth, Ruth was Naomi's daughter-in-law. And Naomi had lost her sons, a Hebrew. She had lost her sons in a foreign land, right? Mm-hmm. I'm just doing a quick overview of that. And so Ruth was young and she was beautiful, and she refused to leave her mother-in-law even though her husband had died.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, where you go, I'm going to go, and your God is my God. Ruth was a Moabite, right?
Mm-hmm.
She was not a Hebrew, okay? Listen up. We get to a point here. Can you read? And so Ruth ended up marrying Boaz. Boaz was a Hebrew.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a rich Hebrew, one of our ancestors. And Ruth ended up, because he heard about her virtuous reputation, and he fell in love with her, and they ended up getting married. Now we just gonna read a short part. Let's read the end of Ruth chapter 4, verses 13 through 22.
Under the heading, Naomi gains a son.
That's the mother-in-law.
Verse 13. So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife. When he made love to her, the Lord enabled her to conceive. And she gave birth to a son.
You hear that? Ruth, a Moabite, gave birth with a Hebrew, Boaz, and had a son. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead.
Verse 14 continues. The woman said to Naomi, "Praise be to the Lord, who this day has not left you without a guardian redeemer. May he become famous throughout Israel."
That's her being offering her son as well to her mother-in-law and said, mm-hmm. "I gave you an heir." Mm-hmm. Okay.
Verse 15. "He will renew your life and sustain you in your old age. For your daughter-in-law, who loves you and who is better to you than seven sons, has given him birth."
Wow. Okay.
"Then Naomi took the child in her arms and cared for him." Verse 17. "The woman living there said, 'Naomi has a son, and they name him Obed. He was the father of Jesse, who was the father of David.'"
You hear that? He was the father. So Ruth and Boaz, a Moabite, had a baby with a Hebrew that would make this baby half Hebrew. And he was Obed, which is the father of Jesse, which is the father of David. So David is, so this was David's great-grandfather.
Exactly.
That Ruth gave birth to, a Moabite, along with a Hebrew. I'm getting to a point here. Stay with me. Okay, finish up the genealogy, honey.
Okay, verse 18 through 22 continues under the heading, the genealogy of David. And we're talking about King David here. 18. "This, then, is the family line of Perez." Perez was the father of Hezron.
Man, as you finish, honey, God goes by bloodline. So that's whenever he naming names, this is very important. I'm going to break this down real simple. Okay, keep going, honey.
Hezron, the father of Ram. Ram, the father of Amminadab. Amminadab, the father of Nashon. Nashon, the father of Salmon. Salmon, the father of Boaz.
Boaz is a Hebrew. Ruth married Boaz. She wasn't a Hebrew, but Boaz is a Hebrew. Okay.
Boaz, the father of Obed. Obed, the father of Jesse. And Jesse, the father of David.
There we go. I'm getting to a point here. Listen up. Ruth was not a Hebrew. Ruth was a Moabite. Okay? Different bloodline. Boaz was a full-blooded Hebrew. She married Boaz. They had a baby. The baby is Obed, which is the grandfather of David, which is the first king of, the second king of Israel, which is a man after God's own heart. Okay, by the time David come along, he was back a full-blooded Hebrew because three generations had passed. And David is the same line that Joseph came from, and which is the Mary to Mary. But also David is the same bloodline of Jesus. You understand that? What am I trying to say here? God used Ruth, someone that wasn't even a Hebrew, to conceive a son with Boaz, and that became the bloodline of David, the land of David, as well as the land of Jesus. That's why when a lot of times, even when I'm calling out in prayer, but they also see in the Bible, we say, "Son of David, have mercy." We're talking about Jesus. He the son of David. He come through the bloodline of David. Now, by the time David was born, he was the third generation, so he was back a full-blooded Hebrew. But Obed, his great-grandfather, was half Hebrew. What am I saying? Am I pushing interracial marriage?
No.
No, I'm not. What I'm saying is God goes by bloodline, not color. Esau taught you that.
So those of you who also have channels who are dedicated to attacking interracial, whether it's marriages or dating, you know, to each his own. But at the same time, understand the history.
Right. You don't know what you're talking about, okay? Don't get me wrong. The Lord, he makes it clear we're not to
intermarry. We're not to intermarry.
But
right.
You have to understand we are in our land of captivity. I'm getting to a point here because that's going to bring me, that's what we're going to go down mm-hmm. to right here. Back, I want to talk about Aisha Curry.
Okay.
Okay. You know, I want to talk about, I know that this happened because they were trending it for 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks.
We don't talk about trends.
Yeah.
You Hebrew Nation, let me tell you something. You took her hair, Aisha's curvy hair, and you wrapped it around your fist and fucking dragged her for 2 weeks over nothing.
She said nothing wrong.
What she said was not 100%, 1,000% completely normal. You Willy lynched. They might as well have been Esau.
Yeah.
They were like racist trolls. It was disgusting.
Very.
They made all kind of videos over something completely normal. Any married woman would know, should know.
Yeah.
Especially if you've been married over 10 years, every mature husband and mature wife, not about age, but as a matter of time you've been, have know that what she said was completely normal.
Especially in a marriage.
In a marriage.
And what I found ironic, babe, a lot of the videos were made by people who are not married.
It was disgusting.
And they're speaking on a married couple. And again, what you don't understand, God has specific ways of doing things. What he brings together, you talk about the wrong marriage, you kind of putting yourself in a very dangerous position.
And what we're saying is this. What was the point? Then we go back to Willie Lynching. You were just as mean and evil as Esau was. That wasn't nothing to drag her about.
It wasn't.
That was, and you know what? The white media didn't even pick it up to y'all asses online dragging her.
Yeah.
Dragging her for no damn reason. That was completely normal. Every wife at some point feel like that. It's not about want male attention. You just want to know
that your husband still find you attractive. Because you got to understand, us as males, sometimes we forget what you did to get your future wife. You have to continue to do those things after you're married.
And we're not saying that Steph Curry isn't doing that.
Right,
I'm
not
saying
that.
Right. I'm saying there's a 95% chance that that could be the case because I would consider 8 years of still a younger marriage.
Yes.
So y'all it takes y'all about a decade
not
to get.
Mention, you have to also take in consideration his profession. He's away from home 6 months out of the year, if not more, because they always go into the finals. So when he is there, I look at it like this. If they've been married 8 years, I say in real time they've been married 4 years because his profession takes him away from the family a lot.
And that's completely normal. I'm not saying that is the case with Steph Curry and Aisha Curry. What I'm saying is it is 1,000% normal for any wife to feel that way because that's an emotional need that every woman has and every mature wife and husband knows that.
Yes.
Just like men need to be affirmed about their careers from their wives, they gotta hear it.
Yes.
A woman has an emotional need to know that she's attracted from a husband. Like you said, they douse our ears when we're dating.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
But when you get married, sometimes that can let up and a woman still needs that.
Affirmation, exactly.
Right, but and that was completely normal. If that would have been like a Kelly Ripa or something, she would immediately a Esau sister. Mm-hmm. She would immediately say, "Oh, I have 3 kids. I can relate to that." Mm-hmm. She would never have dragged one of her sisters like that mm-hmm. the way you all did. It was disgusting.
And I can almost guarantee because I know my wife affirms me a lot. I guarantee you if Steph Curry's wife is not from time to time saying, "Oh, babe, good game. You scored 50 points.
Right.
You did you know you set a record for all these threes you made in one quarter or one game?" If she stops doing little things like that, he's going to be like feel like a certain type of way because women naturally affirms their men.
Yeah.
And us as men don't understand that reciprocation is needed in the relationship to help their relationship nurture and grow.
And we're not saying that is
the case,
but that could be the case.
But that could be the case.
Any wife with any common sense, that's what I'm saying, they don't even use basic common sense, they so Willie Lynch, would have immediately related to that and sympathized with that as another Hebrew sister. That is another thing I want to get about. They got so abusive that they start saying, she not black.
She not even black. Not even Hebrew.
Yeah.
After that story started dying down, here come the colorism.
Exactly. Dragging her because she's light skinned. Are you serious? Are you serious? What's the difference between that and Esau?
Nothing. It's Willie Lynch.
Is what
it confirms.
You are that, so it evil, mean, and nasty.
Exactly what the letter said. They will do it to themselves. It will be self-refueling and self-generating.
And that's what I'm about to. That's why we read the Book of Ruth. God does not go by color. Yes, all Hebrews are of the Negroid race. God goes by bloodline. Okay? You all are Willie Lynch and you don't know shit. Okay? We are in our land of captivity. When I mentioned Aisha Curry in a previous video, I had stated before I even mentioned that example is that I said she has more Hebrew blood than anything else. She has more Hebrew blood than any other bloodline in her. According to the Most High God, now just like Ruth, and just like Obed, David's great-grandfather, he considers her part of his nation. That's for all our biracials.
Yes.
We are in our land of captivity. If you have Hebrew blood running through your veins and you choose to roll with your nation of Hebrews, so somebody like Colin Kaepernick, mm-hmm. So God's going to, if he chooses to be a part of this, God's going to tell him, oh no, you can't come to Israel because you only have half Hebrew blood. No. That's not how this works.
No, it's not.
You don't get to decide who is a part of our nation or not. God does.
Yes.
You Willie Lynch. Esau taught you skin. Y'all going by light skin, dark skin. God goes by bloodline. It was disgusting what y'all did. Abusive. Jesus. Honey, what were you
Wow. Hey, I was going to say shame, shame, shame.
Because you want to talk to them too on this bull crap they
pulled. Yeah. And basically, it was disgusting. This is what I want to say about that. I know a lot of you got kind of hyped up because our last video that my wife and I done together, that was the first time we even addressed the celebrities, Hollywood. Like my wife, like my wife said, God has commissioned us to go get his babies from the hood all the way up to the Hollywood Hills.
Yes. Us.
Us.
Commission us.
So.
Not you.
For all of you who feel like you are us, and I want you to understand this. My wife and I have the anointing, the authority to address our celebrity Hebrews.
Our entire nation.
Our entire nation at that matter, but I'm going to just stick it to that because it seemed like we brought up Aisha Curry and Jada Pinkett in the same video. They miraculously, organically, they met and did a red table talk. Mm-hmm. And so naturally, you would think it happened so quickly. You would think, that thing happened organically, and now it's open season to talk about celebrities. Right. No, one thing you must understand: our Hebrew celebrities are on a different level than you. Mm-hmm. They have wealth, if not access to wealth. They have attorneys, if not access to power attorneys. They can destroy your whole existence or way of life with one phone call for you doing what you did to Aisha Curry.
They can crush your
They ass. Can crush
You're
you.
You're nowhere on their level. You don't have the power, you don't have the anointing, you don't have the authority by God.
And so let this be a warning for you who think that celebrities are open game for your YouTube channels and your channels in general. You do not have the authority. You do not have the anointing or the mantle to address them in those type manners or ways. Mm-hmm. And even when we flex our authority, we are not gonna come at them the way maybe we'll come at the layman. Period. Because we understand levels and lanes.
Right. We love our whole nation.
We love the whole nation.
You called us to galvanize the whole nation. We doing our job. It's not your job to do that. You causing division. Talking about colorism. You call
yes.
Us, saying she not black. You Willie Lynch. Going back Esau's rules. Light skin, dark skin. Y'all all effed up. Go somewhere and learn. Listen to the lessons and shut up. No wonder why he ain't calling
but,
you.
But again, let's go back to the Willie Lynch letter. What did he say? Envy.
Yeah.
Envy. What was the motivational factor for you dragging her like that?
And hatred of your own people, Willie Lynched. That was so mean and nasty for no reason. That was some normal, basic ABC marriage stuff. That was nothing to drag about.
Maybe in their mind, these celebrities don't have regular people problems.
Jesus. And that's why they need to stop
talking. That's why they need to be quiet.
Can we go to Hosea? Let's back this up with some scripture. Okay? Because see, you all got the game, messed up. Okay? Okay?
And if y'all noticing, I'm on my good behavior today.
What does Hosea chapter 12, verse 13 say?
Hosea chapter 12, verse 13, under the heading, Israel's Sin. Verse 13. The Lord used a prophet to bring Israel up from Egypt. By a prophet, he cared for him.
There you go. God uses his people and he uses his prophets. I'm not saying you can't talk. What I'm saying is you're not us. All you doing is effing up, causing more division.
Yes.
Took her hair, wrapped it around their fist, and freaking dragged her for 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
It was disgusting. Really? Over some Willie Lynch, slave mandate, light skinned, dark. Wow. And
the undermining thing was clickbait.
Yeah.
Views.
That's treason.
Likes. Subscribers.
That's treason. You're going against your own nation for your own agenda.
And you have no care in the world about the effect it have on her family. She has children.
Jesus. All over the news. The white media, I watched it with my own two eyes. They didn't even pick the shit up until the Hebrews just kept dragging.
What part of do unto others as you would have them do to you? Would you like your family being dragged in the media by a celebrity? For no reason. And let's flip that. And you have no means or way to even get at them.
Right. And but this is the thing. This is not about Aisha Curry.
It's not.
And celebrities. This is about a code.
And a condition of Willie Lynch that pervades our nation at this time.
Because you dragged her for no damn reason. That was so evil. It was for nothing. That's some normal, basic, foundational marriage stuff. And y'all completely abused her. You were Esau. You were racist trolls. It was terrible.
But babe, as bad as that example was, and as much that could have set us back.
Yeah.
For if we were, if the prophets now weren't on the scene, that would have set us back another 50 years. Just that one instance.
Yeah.
But it got worse.
It got worse with the billionaire.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about that. The billionaire Robert Smith. It's their behavior. Y'all, the Most High is right. You need therapy. You need therapy. You guys are sick in the brain, and it's not your fault. But it's gonna be your fault if you don't change the shit now. It's time for the second exodus. Let me tell you something. We're not taking this to Israel. He'll kill you first. And I'm not saying that to be mean.
No, we're not.
Because they start having light-skinned mobs. I mean, mobs lynching light-skinned people in Israel if they take that shit over to Israel with them. You're just like your damn oppressor.
Mm-hmm.
You're Willie Lynched. Stop it. What were you going to say, honey?
And I was going to just throw this in before we talk about Robert Smith. Some of you that I know for a fact been to our channel partook in the Aisha Curry.
It was disgusting, yeah.
Debate. And the
abuse, Robert.
Abuse, rather. Abuse, because it's not.
They were like Esau. They might as well have been
And some of you who are familiar with our channel, we turn our back and y'all went in on Robert Smith.
Yeah.
Let's talk about, but we do have one other scripture.
The billionaire, okay, Makai. Yeah. Let's hit Makai first.
Before we move on to the billionaire Robert Smith, we're going to read Makai chapter 7, verse 15, under the heading Prayer and Praise. Verse 15, as in the days when you came out of Egypt, I will show them my wonders.
Exactly. That's for the when I said he said he used a prophet to bring you up out of Egypt, and he used to care for them, and he that's what he does. He uses his people. He don't come down here and do it himself. He uses Israel. That's the whole reason he has the chosen people, and he's gonna do it like he did in the days of Egypt. And that is what was my point. You're the servant of the Lord. We are called to galvanize the whole nation. You don't have that authority, okay? With all due respect, you don't. And I see why. You don't even have basic, simple common sense. That's some basic marriage stuff y'all dragged her and abused her about. And like I said, this is not about Aisha Curry and celebrities. Instead, this is about the code.
That's your people, regardless.
That you freaking drag. You, like I said, they were Esau. Like, what was the only thing they're missing is calling her a nigger.
Yeah.
That was the only thing they were missing. It was disgusting.
And the hood had who they really are.
Yeah. 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 And so we want to talk about the billionaire Robert Smith. That was another sickness, stomach turning event this week. We have this billionaire who so graciously gave to 400 Hebrew college educated men he paid their student loans off. Now, I understand that he married to Esau. But you know, you have some silly people that actually claim they know the Bible.
Yeah.
What does the Bible say? It's a time to keep silent and a time to speak.
Yeah.
That was not the time for you to start talking about his wife. This is how Willie Lynch and brainwashed and messed up y'all are in the head. Damn it, y'all need therapy. Listen. What in the change of thought process? That was not the time. If Robert De Niro, I think they got a divorce now, but he was married to a Hebrew woman. He was married to a black woman for 20-something years.
Mm-hmm.
If he gave a $20 million donation to a white charity out here, do you think that white charity would have come out the very next day and call him an in-lover because he was married to a black woman? The ink won't even dry on the check. We won't even know if the brothers got the check yet.
Right.
And they dragging this brother because he married to a white woman. That was not the time to do that, silly. Jesus Christ. Y'all.
You have to understand. The reason that was so big, because we haven't seen it before in that magnitude.
You Willie Lynched.
And that is something to be celebrated. But you couldn't enjoy the celebration. Because you're taught to hate your own people, and so the first thing you do, who is this goody two shoes? Well, who he married to?
Yeah,
and you found one speck, and you went out intently to destroy this man's character and goodwill act from his heart.
That was not the time to talk about his wife. That was the time for you to shut the hell up and be grateful.
Be grateful
that somebody actually did something. And then these be the same ones you say, babe, the celebrities don't help.
Don't help.
I see, look how y'all act.
I see why.
It's disgusting. Listen, we said about the celebrities. There's no cooning in public. You need to roll with your people, support your nation. Damn it, you laymen have a job too. You don't drag. That is still your people. Whether they rich or poor, is still a nation. This is very simple for other nations. You all are Willie Lynch. You're brainwashed. You're indoctrinated. We love our people regardless. Jesus. Honey.
Yes.
That's another thing I want to bring. You know, there was a YouTuber who made a post, you know, about Young Thug's dreads.
Mm-hmm.
And she had said that, man, you know, basically she was giving him a compliment. She was saying, man, you know, his dreads almost look better than mine. She's a female, a woman, a Hebrew woman, young lady. And you should have saw the comment section, honey. It was once again disgusting. It was Willie Lynch. It was very sick. They were calling him all kind of names. They might as well have been racist trolls.
Yeah.
Why do you hate your own people so much? If you didn't have anything good to say about his Young Thug's hair, just how about not say nothing?
Not say nothing.
Why you? And this is not, once again, this is not about celebrities. This is about the code. Any other nation. Listen, at work, I could never walk up to a Latino and start talking about another Latino. I immediately know they're going to shut down.
Mm-hmm.
We don't talk about our own damn people. But we in our infancy stage. Get it together. Y'all better, let me tell you something. Because I'm telling you, this simple for other nations. Y'all better get it together, because you can't take that shit to Israel. Your ass going to be right here. That is sick, demonic behavior. It was taught to you by your oppressor. Stop it. You love each other as a nation. Always. Always. Period. You don't even have to know. All you got to know is, that's a Hebrew. As far as I know, hey, they listen. Unless until they give me reason to think different, they're my people. I don't hate on my people for nothing.
Right. Especially publicly.
Online.
Online, at that. Because see, it's one thing to do a public, you somewhere out and wherever you're at. That's one thing. But when you go online and do this crap, do you know that reaches the globe quicker?
And they don't even have
then basic, you can sneeze.
Yeah. They don't even have basic common sense, because I'm very upset with you women of Judah. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, even dragging Aisha Curry, you didn't have no better sense than that. You women of Judah, especially if you've been married over 10 years, you know that that's an issue.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was nothing for you all to drag her about. We had single men and women talking shit about married people. How you never gonna been talk married, about something you don't even know about?
Never been married. Or have failed at marriage.
With a divorce. You ain't...
They ahead. Have never been divorced.
Right. You're not know, in a position to talk.
To even make a comment.
I'm not saying you can't talk. I'm just saying... This is what I'm saying. Like, I've never been through a divorce. My parents did not go through a divorce. I do not know what that feels like. If someone came to me, I would have to send them to somebody else to minister to them. I cannot relate to that.
Exactly.
That's another part of the Willie Lynch. You don't know your lane. You know, I don't know what make you think you qualified to speak on marriage, and your ass is single.
Exactly.
Really? And that's why you Jesus, wow. Well, if you care to hear it or not, we do love you. But I'm this Willie Lynch brainwashed, slave minded, oppressor of you know, abuse of your own people, because it was taught to you by your oppressor. It has to stop now.
And these are behaviors that was carried down generations from your parents, because that's how they treated people. You saw them as children treating people or talking about people on the phone, gossiping the same way. The only difference is we gossip on the over the internet opposed to one-on-one on our phones.
Right.
Technology right. creates easier avenues to sin.
I'm going to use an example here. And I don't like to use Esau as an example, because they not an their example on how to be wicked, like yeah. the Bible call them. But Esau, I'm going to use them as an example this time, because you all are so brainwashed and really lynched. Maybe you'll get it if I use your oppressor as an example, Jesus.
Usually they don't believe nothing coming out of a Hebrew's mouth unless a white person is saying
it.
Unless Esau is saying it, it must be true.
Right. Okay. You better stop. You better change your thought pattern. That's the therapy he's saying you need. You love your people first, always. Okay.
All the other nations love theirs first.
Right, always. That's the code. That is the code. Okay? Now, Esau, women. Esau's women knows that their man is nothing without a gun.
Exactly.
They know that. They have the weakest man on the planet. They will get their ass kicked by any other nationality of men without that gun. You don't think they women know that? They women know that. Trust mm-hmm. me. But you will never hear them say that in public. Same thing with Esau's men. Esau's men know their women age more than any other group of women on the planet. They know that, don't they?
Age quicker. Yeah.
They know that. Trust me, they know that. But you will never hear them say that shit
out their mouth.
Okay. Asian women, I'm not saying this as a stereotype, but they know their men are supposedly sex symbols. Mm-hmm. You understand? But you'll never hear them say that shit in public.
No, they never will.
Okay, you get it.
But our insufficiencies or deficiencies or lack,
we just air out
everything.
Willie Lynch.
And again, when you are divided, you will fall. When you're together, you can stand. And y'all let the whole world every day, because of YouTube and your thirst for likes, clickbait, subscribers.
Treason.
You commit treason against your own nation every day of the week. because you're thinking about yourself and not the nation, and the whole world is looking at it. Oh, no wonder we have them under our feet. They don't even like each other.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
We don't have to respect them because they don't respect themselves. They will never mobilize together. This is going to go on forever.
Well, they can stay demobilized all they want to. Their ass going to be right here.
Exactly. Okay. You just be demobilized by yourself with your family, your immediate family, and whoever following you.
Because we're not taking this to Israel. Period. Okay? The most I see you now, you know, because I can even say when I use the example about a man, you know, our men, as a group, I have to admit, they're scared.
Yeah.
Okay? And that's a result of getting their asses kicked for the last 500 years. We were under a curse.
Yes.
So when you been attacked for 500 years and God has removed his grace from you, he said, I'm going to turn my face from you. Mm-hmm. That's why we were orphans. We didn't even know we were Hebrews.
Mm-hmm.
When you had go through 500 years of having no wins, it mm-hmm. take the fight out of you. No wins. W-I-N-S.
Yeah.
Right? And so, but what would get rid of that is falling in the land and falling on cold with the second Exodus. Mm-hmm. Another thing, they can be bad bucks.
Yeah.
They date to have sex. They don't date to marry.
Exactly.
That's a problem. But as we beginning to build as a nation, and even we go to Israel, we building. Once men start building, they immediately want help and companion to do that. So that's going to get rid of the lack of wanting to be married.
Yes.
So that'll work itself out as we deal with our oppressor.
Yes.
But you don't bash your men.
And men, you don't bash your women.
Talking about their weed, really? Are you serious? No other man on the face of the planet would degrade his woman the way you all do.
And then there's a thing, and this is what I mean, the destructive nature of Willie Lynch. Okay, so we have the women bashing the men.
You must put male against female. Hold on.
The women bashing the men, these are Hebrews. Then we got the men bashing the women, Hebrews, right? So then what that creates is, okay, the black woman or Hebrew woman says, well, the black man don't want me. I'm going to go and mess with Esau. Vice versa. The black men who are being abused by the black women are saying, well, you know what? Black women is talking down on me. I'm going to go with Becky. And then when they do that, here the same people who created the problem saying, look at this Becky, him with the Becky. Look at her with the Becky. And then when they have problems or fatal problems in those interracial relationships, these same people who kept these debates and these things going, now you want to be the one with the headline story or the clickbait. See what happened when you be in bed with the enemy?
But you
drove your own people there because you abused on both sides by each other.
It's abuse. You all may as well be racist trolls. Just get you a lynch mob, put some damn hoods on your head. You hate your own people.
Well, that's why they call it Willie Lynch, because all you're doing is lynching yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. Stop it. Okay. So we're getting to the end here.
Yes,
okay?
We are.
We almost getting to the end here. Listen. Sorry about that. I told you the Lord told me to tell you the consequences of that. The consequences of you not learning and going through your therapy, which is changing your mindset, getting the Willie Lynch off of you, break that off of you. Love your people. I know that sounds foreign, but every other nation does it. Love your people. I love my people.
I do too.
To death. I love my people, and I would never, even on the job, you know, when I had some Esau come up to me and actually, they're trying to test you to see where you go against your own people.
Yeah.
They know don't even come there with me. I immediately lock up. I'm on cold. I'll never talk about my own people, not with your ass, mm-hmm. ever. Latino, Asian, that's the cold.
And like I said,
never. I don't give a damn what they doing. I don't give a care. Shaquita got on shorts out there twerking, and I'm not talking about her with you.
And like I said before, I'm willing to die for my people, regardless if they support me or not.
Right.
I know it must be done.
Yeah.
Somebody got to do it. I'm tired of waiting on the person to do it. But thank God he actually called me to do it.
Exactly.
That's why I say I love my job. I love my assignment.
Mm-hmm.
My wife know this. When we used to talk about slavery, I said, I couldn't have been living in that time because I just would have been a dead motherfucker. I was not going to take the first motherfucking whipping, let alone you telling me what I can and can't do. I would have burned the shit down and took that consequence. Guess what? I would have still been in heaven.
Nat Turner. Yeah, that's what he did. Okay.
Oh, well, my dead body, I'm going to watch you abuse my wife and my children, let alone think I'm going to let you rape her because you got a fucking gun.
Yeah.
In my goddamn face. Guess what? If God don't want that gun to go off, it ain't going to go off.
But that's why you weren't born in that time.
Exactly.
You, you know, you were born for this time, for the second
exit. Exactly.
That's why you
because he already knew. I couldn't have been born. I would have been a.
You won't be like Kanye West. Slavery was
no,
a choice.
No, okay. No, hell
so,
no.
Right. So listen, you've done.
Yeah, hey, I'm done with that rant. I'm sorry for ranting because I'm trying to better myself.
Right.
Keep my chi in order.
We talked about marriage. Now let's talk about divorce. Okay. I told you we're coming to an end almost here. You know. What do I mean by that? I mean that not only are you Willie Lynch, listen up, I'm talking worldwide, I'm talking to our Hebrew nation. All of you are still mentally married to your captive lands. Okay, listen up. All of you are still mentally married to your captive lands. You so-called Black Americans, you look down on other people in our other parts of the nation, okay? And I know why. Because you say people from Jamaica come here and look down on you, and people from Haiti come down here and look down on you. I get it. But what you failing to understand, you so-called Black Americans, you do the same damn thing.
Yes.
You know when you go to Jamaica on vacation, you red proud that you're an American.
Mm-hmm.
So you mentally married to your captive land too. But listen, Jamaica, Haiti, Trinidad, these are all our people. You Brazilians, y'all over there 40 million deep. Listen, the West Indies, Dominican Republic, not the mixed race, the Negro race, the Cubans, the Negro race, the ones that treated worse,
mm-hmm.
Okay? You Virgin Islands, you UK and Canada, North America. Like I said, all of you, I'm married to your captive lands. I'm American. Matter of fact, they get proud. I'm an American descendant of slave. What the hell was that?
And again, these people are people that she just mentioned in those locations. These are the ones they never show on TV.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You wouldn't even think they exist. They only show the mixed race.
You have to actually travel there to see that they exist, and their conditions are the same as yours.
Exactly. Under the curse of Deuteronomy 28, we are people, we are nation. America, you so-called Black Americans, you have no right to look down on the Jamaicans or Haitians and say that they love their country, they think they better. You thought you was better because you was American, so it's the same thing.
Yeah,
yes,
exactly.
Yes, the Haitians and the Jamaicans was a little bougie, acting like they native to their land. No, they're not native to their land, and neither are you. All of y'all were in error. We a nation. All of us.
And you have your own land, Israel.
Israel, okay? That's how that goes, okay? Divorce these countries in your mind. It's time to go home. Okay, it's time to pop this off. That's what I want to talk about. You know, I want to talk about that. You ready for me to tell them about this vision? Or?
It's up to you. Okay. It's up to you.
So, that I'm bring me to my next point here. You know, like I said in the last point, remember that all of you all were mentally married to your captive lands. It wasn't just the Haitians and Jamaicans and Trinidad, you know, mm-hmm. that were you so-called Americans, you were too. Okay? You can't tell you wasn't American.
We've all been traumatized by this beast.
Exactly.
That they call white supremacy, that we call and know as the myth of white supremacy. Mm-hmm. Cuz nothing supreme about them.
Well, we already know that.
We know that. But from the last 2-3 weeks, obviously they have to be reminded.
Right.
There's nothing supreme about them. You, the Willie Lynch Hebrew, give them their supremacy.
Yeah. Yeah. They won't even say shalom, babe.
They won't even say they're Hebrew.
Yeah.
As if it's not attached to your
inheritance.
Inheritance.
Okay. That's what I want to talk
about. He didn't come back for Black people.
Coming back for the Hebrew
nation. Coming back for his Hebrew nation.
Exactly. God of the Hebrews. That's what it says.
God of the Hebrews. The Most High Yah Elohim is God of the Hebrews. He's not God of black people.
Right.
That's a heart thing. We're so in this infantry stage of galvanization. I will not dare tell you to not call yourself black at this time, because that would do more damage than. But you have to know in your heart, if you don't identify yourself as a Hebrew,
as a nation
of people, and that Israel is your home, and God, Jesus, searches out the hearts of men, if that's not in your heart, there is no inheritance for you.
And that's what's going to bring me to my next point. Like I said, we love you. I know you may not believe it, but you don't understand how much. Like I got the Most High Yah told me, my people need therapy.
You need therapy.
Meaning the change in the thought process.
To the point he actually named the type of therapy that my people need.
Yeah.
Cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, is a short-term therapy technique that can help people find new ways to behave by changing their thought patterns.
Exactly.
Engaging with this CBT therapy can help people reduce stress, cope with complicated relationships, deal with grief, and face many other common life challenges, like that of Aisha Curry, who had a common life challenge that happens in every marriage at some point.
Yeah.
And y'all chose to be Willie Lynch and drag her for something that's common as a cold or a sneeze. If I was a celebrity, I wouldn't give a damn about you.
Yeah.
And you my people. But we're not at that time. We're in a very sensitive time right now.
You love your people.
And you must get this knowledge, and you must understand what time it is.
That's what that means. Loving your people don't mean you know everybody like you know family. Loving your people, when I see a Hebrew, shalom.
Exactly.
When I see, and I never go against my people with nobody, against nobody. Other nations do this. It's simple. Get it done. Stop the willingness.
It also means you don't envy your own people.
Yeah.
If I see anybody, and you got to understand, I see Bentleys all the time. When I see someone driving a Bentley or a model that I like, you know the first thought I have? I can't wait till I get mine.
Right.
I am not thinking, oh, I don't like him. How did he get that? Why he got that? No.
That's the Willie Lynch change.
That's Willie Lynch. That's a difference of thought.
You were systematically trained to hate your own people. Stop it. And I bet I'm sick of this colorism shit. I'm so sick of that shit. I bet not hear that shit. It's disgusting. God goes by bloodline. Right now, like I said, we're in our land of captivity. For our half-blooded Hebrews, if they choose to roll with their people, God said, they my nation.
Yeah.
At this time. Okay? He not gonna, if they choose to roll with Esau, then they go with Esau. But if they choose to roll with they black side, their nation, he said, they got every right in this second Exodus as much as you.
Exactly.
Okay? They didn't pick their parents. Really? You don't go by skin color. You Willie Lynch slave man, the abuser of your own people. Jesus
Christ. Again, shame, shame, shame.
So.
And then you have the nerve to not only want, but expect people to listen to you as if you're giving them something to hold on to.
They're not doing nothing but making a mess.
You're making a mess.
Dividing. Okay.
We're attempting to bridge gaps in our nation, and no sooner than we turn our back, a lot of you, are not only tearing the bridge or the beginnings of a bridge that we're trying to establish, you not only tear it down, you burn it down, and then you go and flood the side we're trying to reach.
And because the way they did the billionaire, Robert Smith, that was just the most stomach-turning, disgusting, dysfunctional. It mutes me. It mutes me. M-U-T.
You couldn't even stay in celebration for more than 10 hours before you had to point out a fault.
Willie lynched. Divisive. That's the whole point of being Willie lynched. Divide everybody.
It almost brought tears to my eyes when I first came across the story.
Yeah. Yeah. And it was not.
Who the hell cares who he's married to when his heart said, I'm going to get back to my people?
Right.
Half of you didn't even know that man existed until he did that. Okay. And then your first thing you do is try to drag him or denounce his gift because of who he chose to marry. Shame on you. And shame on the ones who continue to listen to people like you.
Yeah, it was disgusting.
Because you can't have a voice if you don't have people willing to listen to foolishness.
Yeah.
And that's why Jezebel and her followers will die.
Okay, calm down, honey.
I gotta get back into my chi.
So that's what I want to talk about. You've done.
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay. I want to tell you guys about the vision I had of the Most High about 10 years ago. Okay, I told you that the Holy Trinity introduced themselves to me. Remember, I told you I have a seer's anointing. I keep going back to that. So that's how you can understand how I'm able to see these things. But the Most High, I saw him first, and then I saw the Holy Spirit. I told you in part 6 of lesson 12, my vision of him that I had of the Holy Spirit. He's actually part of the Godhead. He's amazing, right?
Yes.
But I want to tell you how I first seen the Father, okay? Now, my prayer was real heavy at this time, you know, because we were going through a very trying time. And I was doing a lot of fasting and prayer at this time. Our youngest son was only 4 or 5 months old, mm-hmm. you know, and we had a 3-year-old. And, you know, I just remember, I want to explain to you, I'm getting to a point here that says everything to do with our second exodus. You know, visions can come in different forms. I'm not a dreamer. Dreams are when you asleep. I have very few dreams. But visions, you can have them while your eyes open. It's like it zooms you in. That's called an open eye vision, and everything plays out like a movie. Or you can have a closed eye vision, sometime in prayer. There's also different levels of trances, T-R-A-N-C-E. That's when you actually there, mm-hmm. okay? So he brings you, like, I've been to heaven several times. He'll just, like, pull you out your body kind of like thing, right? So this was a trance, okay? And it was very mild because there are different levels of trances, mm-hmm. okay? So what I want to say, I was in prayer. And after about an hour of prayer, I was in, like, this maybe an hour of prayer. And I just remember all of a sudden I could see the throne. Now this still was a vision. I'm explaining that to you. I'm getting to a point here. I could see the throne, and it was pure gold. And I'm gonna tell you right now, the gold in heaven makes the gold down here looks like copper. Okay. It was pure gold. I saw the Father, you know, who's melanated, by the way. I saw the Father, and he was sitting on the throne, and on the side of this huge throne, the light in heaven is so bright, it almost blinds you, you know. It had like 3 jewels on the side, like rubies, diamonds, something like that. Very extravagant. And he was looking straight forward. And I was still down in the earthly realm, and I was praying, and I was thinking, and it seemed like it had just opened up, and I saw it. And I just remember thinking, I'm finally here. I finally reached you, because we've gone through a very trying time. And I was thinking, there's no way I'm going to leave when I see you here. I knew it was him. Okay. And you not know how much I need you to help us in this situation. Well, this is where the trance began. All of a sudden I was there. I was in heaven. And you cannot time heavenly time. It's just, mm-hmm. it's not, you know, if I could put this in layman's time, it would sound like it was 10 minutes, but truthfully, it probably was only about a minute. Mm-hmm. And you really can't heaven doesn't have a time, mm-hmm. you know? And so I remember just crying out to him, help me, help me, help me, you know, and he was looking straight ahead. And I was like, wow, you just ignore me. But he kept looking straight ahead. And then I started singing a praise song in tongues. If you all know, some of you all know about the gift of tongues, spirit, you know, tongues. And at that moment when I did that, he turned his head and started looking at me. And I remember, and that's at that moment, I began to walk towards the throne, on the side of the throne. And I said, oh, praise is what you want. You know, I said, Lord, I love you. You know that. I knew this was the Father. This was the Most High. You guys, his robe was made out of pure gold. I can't even describe the material down here. And he had gold down the seams, you know, of his arm. Just majestic, right? And at that moment, as I began to walk towards the throne, it kind of surprised me. He reached his hand out. And the next thing I know, he had picked me up. He's very big, by the way. In a good way. Like, he's the universe. It's like what is. And meaning, he picked me up and he started. Now, man, you, at the time, I'm 31 years old. I just had a baby four, five months ago. He tossed me in the air three or four times. I couldn't believe it. And he was laughing. It was amazing. And you guys, his presence is so euphoric. The only, get your mind out the gutter. I'm not saying it in a sexual way, because it's not that at all. It's just a euphoric presence that he carries. But the best words I have to describe that is like orgasm.
An orgasm.
You know.
And I can tell you.
Not a spiritual. It wasn't sexual
at all. It wasn't sexual at all.
But that's the best way I can describe it. Go ahead.
When I was a bachelor and I was single, I felt that same sensation when his presence came to me.
Yeah.
It felt like an orgasm. But it was not sexual at all.
That's how euphoric his presence is.
That's how. That's how his presence feels. Like your whole body is having a whole complete body orgasm with no sexual sex happening. If you can imagine that.
If you can imagine that.
And when I say men, when I say it feels like an orgasm, there is nothing coming out. Your whole body is vibrating on such a level of love of this presence that's just can't enter this room. And it's like, what
that's
is
when
this?
That's when he actually blessed you with his presence. Yes. Right? And so he took me up to heaven. So that I was going to continue there.
With you. No.
So that's, and so he was tossing me up in the air, like I was saying, like three or four times. And there was this one man, he was a Gentile Latino too. But there used to be the show called Beyond and Back. And I can tell when these people are telling the truth, which most of them are, where they had death experiences.
Right.
And they may experience heaven or hell or something like that. I can tell because one man said, he said, if thunder could speak, that's mm-hmm. the depth of his voice. That's mm-hmm. like David. And I know that man saw God because that's exactly how he talks. And this one, he's not even yelling at you.
Yeah, this is regular tone, this is regular soft voice. Tone, loving
if,
tone.
Right. If thunder could speak, that's the sound of the Father's voice. And he's like, you know, throwing me up. And then at that moment, he set me on his lap. He's big, by the way. He's the universe, okay? And he handed me a little pink box with a gift on it. And I said, what's this? Because I had a prayer request before him. And he said, your promise. You know, I won't tell you what that is. That was something in our personal lives. And immediately, I was back in my body.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Okay? So I'm getting to a point here. Now, you have to understand, this is the Most High. This is the God. This is the Father. This is the God of part of the Godhead. This is the Father. And that's the experience I had meeting him for the first time. Okay? That he would so graciously bring me up to heaven. He don't come down here like that.
Right.
We've been seeing him down here now, the Holy Trinity. That's because they down here to handle business. When you see him down here, it's serious. Okay? So, saying all that to say, this is the same God that I saw that said in his word, you, my nation, you're the descendants of Abraham. Talking about this second Exodus, mm-hmm. you're my friend. He called us the apple of his eye.
Mm-hmm.
He put his blood in us.
Yes.
His very DNA is in us. He said, I set you apart to myself. Do you understand that Hebrew is the language that's spoken in heaven?
Yes.
The angel came and taught it to Abraham himself.
Yes.
Okay. He says in Malachi, you don't have to read, I was just saying don't read. He says in Malachi chapter 1 verses 2 through 3, he says, Jacob, I love you. That's what he calls us, Jacob.
Jacob.
Descendants of Abraham, my friend. We descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said, Jacob, I love you. He said, you know, and I set you apart to myself. That's particular scripture, don't say it. And he says that, he says, but Esau, I have hated. Mm-hmm. Let me repeat that.
No, let me read that because it's power in the word.
Okay, one, okay. 2 through 3.
So we had Malachi chapter 1, verses 2 to 3, under the heading, Israel Doubts God's Love.
And that's because we've been under a curse for 500 years. He's talking about the second Exodus, and we're saying how, he's saying Israel doubt God's love. You know how you got all these atheists running around, mm-hmm. these Hebrew atheists, and white Jesus, they mm-hmm. mad. So it said, that's what he mean when he say Israel's doubt God's love. Yeah. Okay.
So, verse 2, I have loved you, says the Lord.
He says, I loved you. I've always loved you.
But you ask, how have you loved us?
That's us.
That's us asking ungratefulness. Right. Like, how have you loved us?
Right. We've been under this beast for 500 right. years. Mm-hmm.
The Most High says, was not Esau Jacob's brother, mm-hmm. declares the Lord. Yet I have loved Jacob, but Esau I have hated. And I have turned his hill country into a wasteland, and left his inheritance to the desert jackals.
That's what's gonna happen. They're gonna get nuked after we Exodus. That's what he's talking about. Now, like I said in a previous video, did he create a people to hate? No. And he has his church of Sardis.
Yes.
That's your Esau. That's your Gentile church that he says they have not sold their clothes with evil. And mm-hmm. I have you during this second Exodus.
Yes.
He says it's a few of you that but as a group, I hate these people because of their behavior.
Yes.
Okay. He said, but Jacob, I love you. I've always loved you. He wanted to tempt the whole world to get us, babe. He yes. had to get his kids. Okay? He says, as in the days of Egypt, I'm going to show you my miracles once again.
And wonders.
And wonders. So just go back to what I just explained to you, who I saw sitting on the throne. And this is the very same God that said, I love you. You're descendants of Abraham. You my friend. You my chosen people. Now do you understand the amount of hate that Esau has? Now do you get it? The disdain.
And the amount of love that God the Father, the creator of the universe, have for his people, the Hebrew people. He is willing to tear this whole motherfucker up.
Yeah, to get
his kids.
That's right.
Wherever they at, wherever they dwell.
Exactly, it's that time.
Whether in jail, whether in a pit, whether in a dungeon, whether in Hollywood, Hollywood Hills, whether in Cabrini Green, Ida B. Wells, or whatever project.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that is, now do you understand the disdain that Esau has for us? This is an ancient old battle. Anytime you got a guy like that saying, I love you.
But I hate you.
Now do you understand why they hate us? And you had a nerve to think it's because you're black. Wow. That's why their kids come here, can't stand us.
Yeah.
That's the disdain, that's the hate. Do you get it? You think they get it?
We'll see. Because let us turn our back and not do a video every day. And we'll see if they get it.
And that's what I need you to understand, you know, the venom. And we get ready to close here. But can you just imagine the God that I saw on the throne, the Most High Yah? Wow, like I said, if thunder could speak, if thunder had a voice, that's the depth. He said, like deep warm waters. That's how mm-hmm. he sound, y'all. I'm serious. And can you imagine what kind of wealth we're about to get back? Mm-hmm. Of course, we the apple. He called us the apple of his eye. Okay.
Everlasting, never ending, forever and forevermore.
He said, as long as there's a sun and a moon, Israel will always be my nation. You'll always be a nation. He said, when the sun and moon cease to exist, that's when Israel will cease to be my nation. That's what he said about us. That's why they hate you. You understand? And then on top of it, we had all that wealth and we're about to get it again. That's the jealousy.
Yeah, that's the jealousy.
Okay. That's the disdain. Now do you understand the type of hate? That's why they hate us. Okay. Now, you got to understand, remember our own hospitals, Hebrew doctors,
mm-hmm.
our own schools, teaching Hebrew in our schools, our own government, all that wealth and all that food. Like I said, I look forward to the school. Food. That's the promised land, y'all.
All of our different food cultures are going to come under one roof again.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure the Most High is going to make moderation. There's going to be things that we can and can't partake in, but you know how we do it. Everything, yeah. Everything good. Everything good. And not only is this for ourselves, we're going to be feeding other nations with our stuff.
Yeah, because they owe us interest on that. And that's what we're about to get at, you guys. Listen. We're about to close. Where we at, honey?
We're at 134.
Okay. We're about to close. But I want to talk briefly. This is what I want to tell you guys. That the Lord, I've been seeing the spirit of a plague. It looked more like a death angel, to be honest. Mm-hmm. Okay. And this has been around for a few weeks. And the Lord said it's time to, you know, for the first plague to take place. He mm-hmm. hasn't given a time or a date. Okay. Like he said, my people need therapy. He waiting on these Willie Lynch to get some start galvanizing, like we told you.
But you must understand, he's not gonna do it like the first time and wait 40 years for people to die off. He said no, he's not waiting for anything. He's just gonna.
It's time to pop this off. And that's why he's still trying to give you all a little bit more time. But as we were getting ready to do the video, I said, Lord, you know, remember I told you he always confirmed his prophets.
Yes.
Always. Especially when he calling you to do something this big and epic. And he usually confirmed his office of a prophet through nature or through acts of God. Like the seven churches burning. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times he work in numbers of 7 and 3. That's right. That's just a little sad note. But not always, but that, you know, that seemed to be his MO sometime. But he always confirmed his prophets, especially when he tell you something that big. He told me the first plague, because you know what? Saudi Arabia, that is our shit. That's our land from sea to shining sea. They're over there. And you guys, I'm seeing poisonous, venomous snakes. Okay? I can hear the rattle back. Mm-hmm. Poisonous, venomous snakes. So much so covering the ground, you can't even get a path through, because you got to start clearing them out. Because, see, this is just the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay? And he's going to hit other places with these poisonous, venomous snakes. I told you he about to tear it up to get his kids. Okay? This is one of the first plagues. And he always confirms his prophets. He said, speak that plague that's about to pop off. Okay. He's going to do it in his time when he feel enough of the nation is ready.
Yeah.
Poisonous, venomous snakes going to hit Saudi Arabia and other areas. And his confirmation to his prophet, he told me, he said, speak it against the Middle East. So guess what happened in the Middle East this week? You want to talk about that with Israel?
Yeah, I sent some of you who I know listen to the channel, I sent you the link to the story over the Memorial Day weekend, the last 4 days or so, 3 days. You know, they didn't show it over here. Mm-mm. And I wouldn't if I was them, because you just showing your hand that you already lost the battle. But Israel was burning. There was over 1,000 fires in a, what, 3 hour?
Three day
period. And they said it was so many fires sprouting up everywhere, different places.
All throughout the country.
All throughout the country over there.
Israel.
That on average, a new fire started every 2.5 minutes or every 2 minutes. There was a new fire outbreak somewhere.
They had to call Russia and
They
Iran.
Had to call Russia, Iran, their other neighbors to help send in helicopters to help douse the fire as long as the ground troops. They had to call in Saudi Arabia. They had to call in all kind of people for help.
It over 3 days. Fires were starting every 2.5 minutes. And he always confirmed his prophet. He said, I said speak a plague on the Middle East. I'm coming for it. Let them know I'm coming for it. And he confirmed it. He confirmed it through. And they're saying heat or whatever.
A heat wave.
But it's popping up all over the country. It's not like California where it hit one area then rolled down. Everywhere.
It was just popping up.
Did you hear that on the news?
A 1,000+ fires.
No, the one said 1080. And another one said 1700.
1700. So which is it, Esau? Yeah. Was it 1080, 1,080 fires? Or was it almost 1,800 fires?
Exactly.
In 41 hours.
Right. So, like I said, it's time to pop this off. It's time to get it popping. Don't worry about it, you guys. We got enough money and we got enough talent. We can rebuild certain things. But that's him confirming his prophets. It's time for these plagues to start popping off. It's time for the second Exodus. He confirmed it. That's why Israel burning every 2 minutes.
Yeah. But the main thing
and
is...
And they ain't even telling you.
The main thing, if we're going to talk rebuilding, the first thing that must be rebuilt is our minds.
Yes.
That's the first thing that must be rebuilt is our minds.
And he said, as in the days of when you came out of Egypt, I'm going to show you my miracles once again.
Mm-hmm.
Were you done? I was going to touch on this. And
I'm done, yes.
Okay. So, I just want to talk about, and this is, I want to talk about Halle Berry, you know. See, this is what I'm talking about. Like I said, this is not just about celebrities and laymen. When we call you laymen, I'm talking church talk. We used to say how the pastors and then and the elders, and then you call the church member
the laymen.
So when I say lay, that's not to insult you. I'm saying our regular Hebrew nation.
Regular nation, right.
Right, okay. So this is not, it's not just about celebrities. It's in a, it's about a code for everybody, for the Hebrew celebrities, for the Hebrew laymen, for our whole nation. We are people. We are people. You get it? And I think that Halle Berry, I'm mentioning her because she did an amazing thing, and this is what you call keeping a code.
Yes.
Okay? And I'll let the journalist tell you in her own words. But, you know, she was on cold, and that's what we want more of you Hebrew celebrities. That's what all y'all start doing. Everybody start doing.
Yeah.
Because, like the journalists will tell you, they let Halle Berry interview everybody. Interview with all the Esau journalists.
Mm-hmm.
On the red carpet event, but it was time. It was only two Hebrews on the carpet,
and they always put them at the end.
And always she explained
at events
that,
like this.
At events like this, and when it was time for them to interview Halle Berry, they told them they out of town.
It seemed like Asian assistant told them that
she's mixed.
Well, I don't get into the mixed stuff.
Yeah,
I want to just say her agent or her assistant let the Hebrew journalists know that she doesn't have time. She had to go to the next part.
Right, and Halle Berry caught that.
And
shit.
Halle Berry caught it
and was like, and she said, I can't. You gonna have me skip my brother and sister? I have to talk to them. I can't not talk to them. It was amazing.
It was amazing.
And that's what you call keeping a code.
And we thank you, Miss Halle Berry,
yeah,
for not only catching it, but understanding the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Because what you don't understand, that transaction that happened in that moment, there was no money exchanged.
Mm-hmm.
There was no deals made.
It was just the code.
It was just but what you did, that seed for that Hebrew woman journalist and that Hebrew male journalist, they will carry that seed of kindness,
yeah,
the rest of their lives. And guess what? When God elevates them in their professions and they get as big as some of the biggest names now,
mm-hmm,
they're going to always remember that act.
Yeah.
And they will never be too big for the ones coming up under them.
Exactly.
They will never not give the same time you gave to everyone else to the one at the end.
And that's
because you sold that act of kindness in their life, and they know it's possible. If you can do it, all of them can do it.
Exactly. And that's what you call a code. And that's what a code does. It brings out more love,
yes,
in the nation.
Yes.
That's what we said. Get rid of the Willie Lynch and get your asses on code. Okay? This is not an option. Okay? We are people. And I want to play that because Halle Berry was an amazing example of that.
Yes.
And you know, I'm also going to play a clip of some island music from the Caribbean island that we have. You know, and are we playing Trinity on this video?
No.
Okay.
No.
So that's it, Hebrew Nation. We love you. I know it don't seem like it, but you don't understand. We do. We love you.
We love you more than you can ever imagine.
Yeah.
And before we go, before
it's
I say
time,
goodbye.
It's time to pop the second exit off, y'all.
Before we go, I do want to give the definition of what repent mean, because we hear it a lot, but not too many of you, and I'm not talking about the ones who call on our people to repent.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about the actual people who need to know what this means. Repent, as a verb, means to feel or express sincere regret or remorse about one's wrongdoing or sin, to view or think of an action or omission with deep regret or remorse,
mm-hmm,
or to feel regret or penitence about. So basically, if you felt any type of arrow that hit your heart chakra because you fell into one of these lanes of Willie Lynch in the past 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. The Most High is not upset. He expects that. But when you know better, he expects you to do better because, see, once you know and you still don't do what you know better to do, now you have to deal with him.
Right, that makes you a reprobate.
That makes you a reprobate, and you have to deal with him. Mm-hmm. And we're just trying to let you know. Now that you know, you know.
My people need therapy. Get on therapy. Change your thought process. He said that's the therapy.
That's the therapy you need. And you can do that wherever you at, from within. Change your mindset. Change your thought patterns. You change your life. You change the world.
That's right.
So, till next time, family, again, we love you. We thank you guys for your support and looking at the videos.
And rejoicing. Be glad. And rejoice. Exactly. We're about to pop this off. It's time to get this party started. Oh, yeah. That's another what I want to say, too. The whole point, and we getting ready to close, the whole point of the players, like I said, the only way it's going to stop is they're going to have to contact the prophets.
Yeah.
And that's how we're going to get a seat at the table. That's how this going to pop up. What are you going to say when you...
The only question I have for any of these motherfuckers, where's me gold?
That's right.
That's it. I don't want to hear shit else. Where's me gold? I don't want to hear about nothing else. Mm-hmm. Where's my land? Where's my Solomon's gold? And where's God's precious treasures?
That's right.
If you don't have no answer for those three, we're going to fuck you up.
That's right.
Until next time, family. Shalom.
Shalom, family.
Oftentimes, Black reporters and Black outlets are pushed to the end and unable to get the proper interview that they need. Well, tonight, Halle Berry interviewed with everybody. As she approached myself and I was the only Black woman on the carpet, and there was only one Black male. As soon as they got in front of Lamar and myself, her PR said that she had no time to speak to us. And they began to walk away.
Sorry.
Can we just do a group? One group?
Anything, because we're doing group print. And they're already starting at the theater.
And, you know, I prepared all day. I was super excited. Who doesn't want to talk to Halle Berry? You know what I mean? And she looked at me and she looked at Lamar and said, no, you guys are going to have me skip. I can't skip my brother and my sister. And she turned back around and walked right up to us and we interviewed her. And I feel like, I'm not going to lie, I don't know why I got emotional and I still am, but I take so much pride being Black and being one of the only Black faces in so many spaces that I'm in. And I just felt like for her to turn around and
get... Oh my God, Lamar Dawson.
The opportunity, I have a newfound respect for
her. It was hard. You know, I never worked that hard.
I just want to encourage every Black woman and male to continue to break barriers in all of these industries. Because our faces will be seen and our voice will be heard.
Halle Berry! Halle Berry!
Shalom, my Hebrew nation. I want to thank you for listening to the video. And as always, I urge you to share it on all your social media platforms with all Hebrews. You can also visit our website at www.thiro.org to learn more about our mission and to donate towards the fulfillment of God's agenda. What is the agenda? Your donations will in part help the channel grow by supporting the business operations, but mainly and most importantly, funds will help us go before the United Nations to collect our reparations. Again, my name is Daria, and I am the servant of the Lord that the scriptures speak of in Isaiah 49. For I know that I have not come to convince you, but rather to fulfill a mission I was born to do. I walk in the office of a prophet and have been spiritually anointed by the Most High Yah. For Esau's reign is over and the reign of Jacob has begun. Like many of the biblical prophets before me, such as Moses, they were given armor bearers as referenced in scripture, Micah 6:4. Moses' armor bearers came in the form of his sister Miriam and his brother Aaron. I have been most honored that God has sent my Miriam and Aaron in the form of my beautiful and God-fearing wife, Aisha, who's also a prophetess. In closing, the time has come to begin the process of divorcing ourselves from this country and preparing our mind, heart, and souls to flee Babylon. We cannot go anywhere without money or land. The Lord is going to use me to drive out the Gentile northern horde currently squatting on our land by speaking judgments and plagues. Daughter Babylon and the European nations will be plundered, and we will collect our reparations and return home. To my Arcturian Council lightworkers scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, assigned to assist and guide me in the completion of this mission, I say to you, I'm here. I'm ready. Let's do this. Shalom.
Why do you got your hands down? But you know how I put up on your time. The heads you got, I'm jumping all around. They don't know when I'm gonna show. Time to let it fly. 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 I'll let it fly. Time to let it fly. Time to let it fly. Time to let it fly. Give me the space and I'm pulling up on you from deep. This really easy, yeah, I can do this in my sleep. I make it splash like I'm one of the brothers. My jumper wet as a puddle. Give me the ball at the end of the buzzer. I win it like none. I'm about to get in my bag, boy. Give them whatever they ask for. I let them fly like I'm checking their passport. And it's not hitting the backboard. I make it splash like jumping in bathwater. Pull up like I'm in the drive-thru. Pull up again like I got a bad order. I might just shoot this from half court. You know I've been in the lab, boy. They better do something to stop me soon. They better guard me soon as I come out the locker room. Time to let it fly. 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 Why do you got your hands down? But you know how I put up on you. The heads you got, I'm jumping all around. They don't know when I'm gonna shoot. They better guard me when I get the inbound.
Best of up.
You know it's a bucket if you got your hands down.
Bang, bang, bang.
I grind every summer, so it's going in now.
That's right.
None of my jumpers is touching the rim. I pop the net, it be stopping the game. I try to pop it again and again. I don't get tired, I be letting it fly. I shoot the same from beginning to end. No one can stop me, look, no one can stop me. I promise you, no one can stop me. I let it fly with a hand in my face when it going. I don't even watch it. You try to play up, that's when it's a layup. Look all this jelly I'm dropping. Stop all the talking, I'm going for 30. You better tell them to guard me. They gotta be honest, look, they can't do nothing about it. Yeah, I put it up in the air. Look, it's hitting nothing but bottom. Time to let it fly. 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 Yeah. Why do you got your hands down? But you know I pull up on you. The heads you got, I'm jumping all around. They don't know when I'm gonna shoot.
Coming May 13th. Pre-order the God Box right now.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully out the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi, I just need mighty guard. My Uzi ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi, I just need mighty guard. My Uzi
fully out the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully out the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi, I just need mighty guard. My Uzi ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi, I just need mighty guard.
I swear on my Melina soul, my grandmama, that old cold, that Mississippi, that dirt road, this barefoot, that bare soul, I better load, oh, solo by myself, dolo, frodo from Lord of the Rings, so I guess I have to bear it alone, my precious won't leave me, I don't need platinum, I don't need gold, all I need is a Uzi and a clip to load, this one mic, this Jordan flow, trying not to wear Jordan clothes, these kids are dying, Jordan no, Nike 2, Vanport, Portland, they blew it up, Black Commerce, they chewed it up, shoot it up, spit it out. That's the kind of shit I'm trying to spit about. Last laws, politics, politics is a pile of shit.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
I'm getting real close now, smelling it.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. My Uzi
lied.
My Uzi
smelling it.
My Uzi,
you lied.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully out the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard. My Uzi ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard.
My Uzi.
My Uzi weigh a ton, pray to God to stay protected. High alert, I see jackers on the creep in my reflection. Law, ain't nothing been promised late. Police out your acting crazy. Shooting up black folk left and right. People out your die every night. Mama worry about me all the time, cause I'm grind. Trying to make a move, cause the government don't give a fuck about pro folk. I just paying dudes, trying to keep the food on my table. My family fed in my mind right, and I attitude just in case the motherfucker wanna take my limelight. I got 100 rhymes drawn. If you're talking about broke rhyme here, on that KK. K shit, make it where your clan can't come down here. How the fuck that? I been known once and they kill Mike. In a jury holler, not give the fuck. I put my faith in God, cause that's all I know in this.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
I got 100 rhymes,
I got 100 rhymes.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Where your clan can't come down here.
I been known once and they kill Mike. In a jury holler, not give the fuck. I put my faith in God, cause that's all I know in this. My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully out the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard. Ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard.
Now my shoulder hold an AK that hold enough shots. Let enough cops know that I ain't going out without a fight. City be burned down by the night. Yeah, I be raving about Baltimore. Talking about taking shit out of the store. Mind as an eagle, my people protecting. You step in my sector, you got to go.
Boom, 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 boom.
I'm about to blow. Pig, yes, you or it's me. This one the black skin, so it's happening. Homie, fuck what you see on TV.
You don't see.
They say this shit is about black and white. All this shit is pretty Freddy Gray. Swings and seesaws, rusty in the sip. Trust me, pimp, we don't never play. They say, day, I'm quite cheap. No nice cars, just nice beats. My little revolver, my problems all with some red hoes and them white sheets. And I might preach with this Glock 40. Respect mine with this Tech 9. Get my old lady, little 380. But it jam easy, let me check mine. My Uzi weigh a ton. Heavy as all the shit that they done done.
My Uzi weigh a ton.
And I won't talk this shit till I'm done. I'm on the run, I can't sleep. My food poison, I can't eat.
My
I can't break, I ain't fit. My
brain
is something that you cannot take.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully at the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Got nobody guard. I just need mighty guard. My Uzi ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard. My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it.
Fully at the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. Ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi just need mighty guard. My Uzi ain't got nobody guard. My Uzi weigh a ton.
Fully at the foreign, nigga.
My Uzi weigh a ton,
I got a chance to travel internationally, and I got to see the way that America was depicting black men. And for the most part, it was rap videos, and at that time, that's when reality TV shows had just started. And like, we looked really bad. And I was a real big part of that. And I just couldn't do it no more. Like, no matter how much money people paid me at that time, I just couldn't continue to send black people's images to hell.
My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. My Uzi weigh a ton, I bought it. My Uzi. My Uzi. My Uzi. My Uzi. My Uzi weigh a ton,